Hi folks, how you doing? Kel here. Well, this may be a new era in Kel's video making. I may make a sea change. To start with, I'm going to show you what I'm doing here. I got my new, what I think is a lumberman. Some might say it's Canadian. I think lumbermans have a rounder shaft and they're long. This is almost 7 inches long. Maybe it's just a large Canadian. I don't know. I think lumbermans have a long shaft. You know, we all know lumbermans have a long shaft. I don't know that personally, not knowing any lumbermen myself, but I assume they do because lumbermans have a long shaft. Long shaft is a good thing. I don't have a long shaft. Anyway, but I've got this, and this, by the way, is a sitter. This is my new pipe. I got this, the one I got from England. I probably have not posted that video yet where I bought this on eBay. I don't think I posted it, so I'll post it thereafter. And I'll talk about this a bit. But you know, the thing is, it actually is a sitter. I found this just now. This will sit on flat surfaces pretty much. Jiggly, they'll probably fall over, but that's kind of cool. I don't have any sitters. Make a good poker pipe. Anyway, got my cell phone. My iPhone, which I can have stuff on to talk about. Got my lighter, which I just refilled because I smoked a pipe last night and smoked a bunch of stuff. I've got my little pipe tool and my water sitting here, which I always have sitting nearby. It's usually I do. The last few videos I forgot to do that. I should keep the water here. It helps the tongue bite a bit. And I got my ashtray. It's just a bowl. I've got actually a nice ashtray, but I don't want to leave it out here because I'm afraid someone's going to stink up on my deck and steal it or something, or who knows what, or it'll get, you know, wrecked. The thing is, I made this video, and this is my first smoke of this, by the way. I cleaned it last night. I got this in yesterday. It came from England, and like I say, I did a package opening last night for this, by the way, too. So you're going to see this video first, because I'm posting this tomorrow, I think. You're going to see this video first, then I'll post the package opening video, and then this one, too. But this was bought. This left England on the 29th of June, and it got here yesterday. That's on the 6th, or 5th, 6th, yeah, 6th. Which means it only took like six days or so to get here really fast. I was shocked it was here. Usually when I get something from a foreign country, it takes me, you know, it's 2 or 3 weeks at least, if not a month, you know. But this came really quick, which is really cool. So I'm going to light it up here. What I've done is I put some BCA in the bottom of this. I'm not really very happy with the BCA I got. I'm not really enjoying it that much. It's impossible to keep lit in my pipes. But I put some BCA in the bottom here. I've got some old McClellan's Vanilla Black Cavendish, VBC, which I like the flavor of better, but it's just like little dust. It's almost dust. If you can see that, it's almost dust, and it's hell to have in the bottom of my pipe because it comes right through the stem. So the BCA is only being used as dottle and as a filter, so I don't get a bunch of stuff in through the pipe. So, Jesus, that's awful. Good Lord. I just filled this thing, so the flame's trying to go crazy on me here. This thing was held clean. It looked really clean out of the box, and the guy said he only smoked a half bowl, which I don't think is true. I'm sorry, but don't want to call the man a liar. But I think he must have smoked quite more than that. Not a lot, but I mean, it's still pretty much like new. But it has a real kind of a ghost to it. It's a bit ghosty. I'm tempted to salt and alcohol clean. I scraped out all the old cake. There was very little cake in it. But I scraped it out. And I alcohol cleaned the stem, cleaned the living daylights of this with soap and water, and then alcohol, and then cleaned daylights out of the shank with alcohol, and it's clean now, but it's still a bit of a smoke, a ghost in the pipe. Ooh, a ghost. For those who don't know what that means there's still a taste left over a little bit. You say you only smoke Virginias? That's probably true. It's a Virginia ghost from the state of Virginia. Anyway, I haven't really been enjoying my pipe tobaccos lately. I've enjoyed a few, really, one really a whole lot, and not at all. I've had some problems with this lane limited BCA, keeping it lit. Anyway, on to the topics. I got a very loving reaction. I was going to say big reaction, but it's really kind of a loving reaction from my video I posted yesterday on Monday. Well, today's Tuesday, yeah, yesterday. Well, it'll soon be Wednesday here because it's like 11:30 at night. But I got a lot of love from the viewers on that video. To be honest with you, quite honest, I just posted that almost by accident. It was my first video of a series of like 19 I made the other day, and it was the first video in line. I clicked on it and I thought, okay, I'll just post this one. You know, I didn't have it. What I'm saying is, I hadn't titled them yet. I usually go through, when I put the videos on my computer, you know, they're 0000001 0002, you know, they're like that. They're misnumbered. I don't know what they are. Once I make them, I, you know, no clue. A day or two later, I have no idea what I've said. Because my brain is fucked. And, so, I just clicked on that one, and it was kind of a ramming video at first. Then I realized once I uploaded it was about my five favorite cigars too. A lot of it was just rambling. I'm getting a lot of feedback from viewers today of how much they enjoyed that video. They really loved it. And for me, it's weird because I feel guilty posting those kind of videos, you know. Usually when I make a video, I'm using my iPhone. I'll go to my notepad section of the iPhone, and I'll post a topic I want to talk about, you know, and then I'll just talk about that subject, you know, try to get the information I want to get across in the video. Whereas that video was kind of more rambling with a general topic, you know. The thing about it is with me and videos, the videos I don't like making are the informational videos as much, because I'm trying to do a specific thing, you know, and a specific topic, and I've got things I want to get across, and it's frustrating for me because I have a very poor memory. I think I do really well considering that. But it's still frustrating. I'm trying. My biggest problem I have in life, by the way, is trying to. I try too hard at everything, and I screw everything up because of it. And, you know, I'm watching a lot of Howard Stern lately on YouTube. I used to watch his show religiously every day when it was on E, you know, on TV. He had a TV show as well as a radio show on E, and I watched it every day. When he went to Sirius Radio, I was really bummed out. Damn, camera doesn't seem to be right. I'm trying to figure out. Anyway, when he did that, he stopped making videos for E. The E thing, E thing went by the wayside, which really bummed me out because I was religious about watching the show. When I first heard about Stern, somewhere, you know, the person said Stern was an obnoxious, evil, mean, disgusting New York Jew. That's what they said. I'm like, you know, I practically expected to see a guy wearing horns when I looked at the show. I thought, boy, this guy's mean. He's a nasty guy, you know. And that's what I would hear on the news and not everywhere, you know, they weren't being racist. They're just describing him, you know, as a Jewish person who just has a nasty, mean, angry. And I found him not to be that way. I found Stern be a funny guy, you know, and an interesting guy to watch. He speaks his mind. I think he gets the nasty reputation because sometimes in the early days before E, even if someone would call up and criticize him, he would just go off on him and say all this stuff. But even that, well, I've seen him do that once or twice. Even that's kind of a joke. It's kind of tongue-in-cheek in his case. He's doing it as a bit, you know what I'm saying, as comedy. So the ones I've been watching are the ones with Artie Lang, the comedian, great comedian, and sadly heroin addict, and you know, and Fred's there, and Benji, and most of all Sal and Richard, who I get a big kick out of. I'm watching these on YouTube, and they're uncensored for the most part, which is cool. I mean, there's nudity and everything; it shouldn't be. I'm sure YouTube will get rid of that in time. But these are the ones that he did for Sirius Radio. And he had like a pay-per-view, on-demand, you know, TV show for Howard Stern, which I can't afford that kind of stuff. I've been really watching the last few days and really, really getting into, really enjoying them immensely. And I always did. And why I tell you all this is because this is almost a church warden pipe in a way. I can put my arm down here and some of the videos I admire the most on YouTube are things like Stefan Molyneux, who's a libertarian, you know, and he makes these long videos that are like a, you know, half hour, even sometimes an hour and a half long, you know. He rambles on, but he rambles in a very specific way, you know what I'm saying? He's very sharp, he's got a very sharp mind. So he's got this stuff in his head. Though actually, you know, he reads it, something I just realized, he reads it actually. He actually reads it off of a teleprompter into the camera, come think of it. And then he comments, and then he goes away from the I just realized he does that, doesn't he? What I'm saying is, probably two kinds of videos, ways of making videos. And the one is where you have it all prepared, written down. Maybe it's even a comedy skit, you know, or comedy jokes, or it's all written down like Stefan Molyneux. Karen Strongheim is another one who reads stuff in front of the camera, reads it. She's not saying that, you know, from memory. She's not talking about that memory. There's those kind of videos. And then the videos that are very professional, where someone comes on, you know, and they got a bunch of jokes prepared, comedy jokes. And they, you know, they say a bunch of stuff, you know, and like Fred and stuff and all those kind of channels, you know, and you know that, what's that? Daily Three or whatever it is. I don't like my son used to watch a guy. He's got a regular studio and he does these presentations, which are all mapped out, you know, none of it's really off the cuff. And that's what I'm talking about when I'm talking about my How to Smoke a Pipe series, stuff like that, you know. Those are videos which they're not mapped out really, but I have an idea what I'm going to talk about. And then I just do it off the top of my head, bearing in mind what the subject matter is. I'm doing that right now to some degree. Because I'm getting at something here. I want to make videos that are likable. I would love to have a successful YouTube channel. And I'm not trying to be a dick here, but my channel, you know, because I know a lot of you guys watching have YouTube channels too. You make videos and don't have near the viewers I do. I'm not trying to be an ingrate. I love the viewers I have. But I'd love to have, you know, some real viewership, like Stefan Molyneux or something like that, where I get, you know, 10,000 views per video or something. I know it sounds terrible, but I'm not taking what I have for granted. The reason why I continue to do videos is because I do have a start of a good channel, I think, after 700 and something videos. I finally got a start. The point is, you can do videos in a very, and I've tried doing that, you know, kind of having a plan, and like I'll get these topics and put them on my cell phone. I used to put them on paper, and I'll pick a topic to talk about, and I'll stick to that topic, and I'll do that thing, you know, and try to make kind of a presentation, you know. But I don't remember things well, so I can't actually memorize something. I don't want to just sit here and like, hi, my name's Cal, and read something off of paper. I think that has a lot of talent to it, even though some of those videos are very good. And Karen Strongheim does that, and Stefan Molyneux, and a lot of others do that. I don't really want to do videos like that, really. Never have. I'm not going to do that. You know, I've thought about it, but that takes some of the spontaneity away. I'm going to get to it here. So I'm watching Stern the last few days here, and then I make this video of the day, which was kind of a rambling video. And I stray off the topic, you know. I was going to talk about the 5 cigars, but I started talking about something else, and I talked about the cigars. And when I put it up, I didn't realize what it even was. It was a video. I watched the first couple minutes of it, but I didn't realize until I put up that it was about the 5 cigars thing. I had to change the name of it, you know, when I was uploading. You know, I'd forgotten it was. I didn't realize the 5 cigar thing was in there. And it's real popular. I mean, I don't know how I have a lot of views there yet, but people really enjoy the video. When people come in there, you know, like the gentleman scholar tonight, and that's got me going. Thank you, sir, by the way. I appreciate it. I was going to say his first name, but I'm not sure people know his first name. I don't know if he wants his first name out there, but he came on. He said, you know, hey, I really enjoyed this manly man kind of a video talk, you know, here. I've had videos like that before, where I just kind of rambled and talked about things, kind of what I call fireside chats, you know, and people have very responded very, very, very warmly to them. It's not so much about views, but when people go out of the way and say, man, I really love this video, you know, that's kind of rare in a way. People say, I like your videos, but people say, I just love this video, it was so nice, so relaxing, whatever, you know, enjoyed watching it, you know. That's a good thing for me, I like that. I had several people do that on that video so far, and I'm like, I'm embarrassed to post videos like that. I think it's lazy. I mean, because it's not hard to do videos like that, just to sit and ramble and talk. I feel even now, just talking like this, I feel like I'm being lazy. I'm not doing a good job, you know. I'm just jerking off here on camera. But you know, what I mentioned the Stern thing is, I watched this movie again, Private Parts, which I've seen before. And that movie, it's all about his struggles as a radio personality, you know, as a radio guy. And how inept he was initially. And he was very inept. If anybody is struggling to do anything, you know, the first time I played a hand of poker, you know, it was very inept, you know, even though I studied it a bit. The first time anybody makes love, they're generally pretty inept, even if they've studied it, which I had. I'd read books on the whole subject of sex long before I actually made love. I mean, I read several books. I was intensely interested in that as a young man and realized that, you know, it's just not something that comes natural. That's why I'm so good in bed. That's why the ladies love me. That's why even when I have a horrible breakup with a girl, she still wants to have sex with me later on. It's handy. Anyway. You know, watch Stern, and his movie talks about this, how he comes in one day and says, you know, I'm not going to talk about what I normally do, or do this or that, or the other thing, or prepared stuff. I'm just going to talk about my life. I'm just going to talk about stuff in the camera, you know, he said in his movie, you know, and he starts doing that, you know. He comes in one day and starts talking about how he's not getting enough sex from his wife, and how he wants to bang her, and she doesn't want to, and all this stuff, and talks about his real life. And watching these videos on Sirius, from Sirius Radio last week here, you know, what's interesting about it is, you know, he even says that. They've talked about it several times in the show, and they've had these horrible, horrible fights in the show. You know, he's talked about, they say, well, listen, the show is based on, it's based on honesty, and really how we feel about things. So they have these big fights, you know, and Artie's angry, and there's one where Artie threw something at Sal, and some of it was really hard to take. I mean, there was one between Artie and Howard, which was just, I'm surprised he didn't quit or something. But the whole idea of that show is to be true, to be real, to keep it real. Not like, you know, you watch like Fox and Friends way late at night. You know, they have these guys on, there's three people on the couch, and, hi, how you doing, Joe? Oh, I'm doing fine, you know. Well, what do we have today first? Well, there's a story about this and that, and this guy was sucking this other guy's cock, and he got shot in the head with a .22 pistol. Well, that's exciting. That happened all the time over in that area. Well, it happens often, you know, who knows. And a girl joined in, and she was getting banged, and she got shot in the head with a pistol, too. It's the strangest thing, you know. They have these stories they do, you know, it's all phony, and, you know, it's, you know, it's like all TV shows, that kind of stuff like that, you know. Even reality shows are kind of phony. But Stern shows not really. I mean, they do some bits. They do bits and things. It's true. But his show is kind of based on reality. You know, when they have these fights and stuff, it's real. It's, you know, sometimes they know they know it's good. They know it's good television. They know it's good radio. That's true. That's true, honestly. But still, it's still kind of real. You know, it's. What I'm saying is just him kind of rambling sometimes and talking about stuff and bringing things up, and then he talks with the others and stuff, and that's what it is, you know. So what I'm saying is, in a roundabout long, long, long way in my way, is that on the one side of YouTube, you've got videos which are carefully architecture, you know, there's careful architecture They're edited very carefully. They got intros and you know, all that stuff, you know. And on the other side of YouTube, you've got me. Actually, I was kind of in the middle where I make specific videos about specific topics. But what I'm doing right now is the other side, where it's kind of the Kel Show, you know what I'm saying? I'm just talking to you about stuff that's on my mind. I did write down a couple different topics tonight I want to talk about. I may make a different video, but I may just talk about them, you know, just make this one video, one big, long, boring video, you know. But I've struggled the last few years with YouTube and what I should make it, you know, and I had to finish all those How to Smoke a Pipe videos, which are all, those are all pre-planned, you know, not edited really, but they're pre-planned videos, you know, that I'm trying to have a specific intent in mind, you know, to get information across, you know. I've struggled with that. I've struggled with, you know, and I don't really like making those. I mean, I like making them for you guys, to help you guys out. I think men should help their fellow men. I think it's important. And that was the original idea. But they're not fun to make. You know, it's one reason I got burned out and didn't make videos for 8 to 9 months. So I was trying to finish that series and it's frustrating to me because I can't really, they're never good enough, you know. Those videos are not good enough. They're never good enough for my taste, you know. They're not good enough. And it drives me crazy. I'm not happy with how they come out. I try to make them good and, you know, I'm just not capable of, you know, doing good videos like that, really. You know, not in my opinion anyway, you know. But this kind of video here, like one I made and I put up yesterday, you know, on the 6th or whatever it was. You know, that video was fun to make, you know. I enjoyed making that immensely. And then people enjoyed watching, you know. You know, it dawned on me tonight when I was looking at gentlemen's scholars' comments that, you know, it was a 26-minute long video, way too long. But some of Stephen Mullen's videos are an hour and a half long. And I've watched his. And I'm watching these Howard Stern videos on YouTube right now, which are somewhere 2 hours long. And I'm enjoying them. And what I mean there is that when I first got on YouTube, a fellow YouTuber, who I shall remain nameless, wrote me a message. We weren't friends or anything. He's just a fellow YouTuber in the pipe community. He wrote me a message and said, you know, Kel, your videos are too long. I made like a 7-minute long video. He said, Kel, these videos are too long. Don't make videos that long. You're boring people and that's not good. You want to make short videos. And I've always had that in my mind. My videos should be short and quick and I never can get them to be that way. But the point is, if I enjoy watching Howard Stern videos where they just talk about stuff that happened during the day. I just got done watching a half an hour one. It was all about Ralph, his hairdresser, you know, who's his, you know, hairdresser clothing guy. You know, he's a real character, kind of a nut in a lot of ways. And how Stern's pissed off because Ralph came over to his house and he was sick and, you know, saying he'd thrown up and all this weird stuff. All this weird stuff is going on, and they're arguing, you know, kind of, you know, and then there's all this stuff. And it's about daily stuff, you know, it's not really, it's, you know, none of it's planned out, really. I mean, the theme of Howard, he will plan to talk about things. He'll get to the studio, and that's what he did here, you know, because what happened, they have an after show, and the day before, Fred had called him to the after show, and Stern was in his car, and he heard what Ralph. But Ralph was saying he got pissed off and he called the after show. So this next show, the one I was watching, was all about him calling in and talking to Ralph on the phone about it, you know, what Ralph had been doing and acting weird and irritated Howard and all this stuff. And then Howard and Ralph were friends, you know. Ralph is weird. So that's the whole show, you know. It's reality, basically, in a sense, you know, reality show. It's not, they don't have lines, they're all, you know, it's not all written out. Even like a lot of reality shows, it's all written out, it's all bullshit, you know. It's all written out. But these guys, actually, they argue and they fight. And not that I plan on having any arguments on camera with, you know, myself. Kel, why did you say that? You son of a bitch, I hate you. No, don't hate me, I'm right about this. Oh, fuck off, you asshole, I quit. And I leave, and then the camera's blank, you know. I'm not going to be doing that. But if Stern can sit there and talk to the camera and in the radio and talk about stuff, and he has people he talks with, I don't, but I have no problem talking, believe me, I'm a big blabber mouth and you all know it. But if he can do that and people enjoy it, maybe I can. And I was really excited about coming out here and making this video because, you know, this would be... In fact, a couple years ago when I was getting close, when I thought I was getting close, getting finished with my How to Smoke a Pipe series, there was a time I got the same idea and I was like, wow, wouldn't it be nice just to sit in front of the camera and smoke a cigar, a pipe, and talk about general stuff? I've been making MGTOW videos, you know, men going their own way videos, you know, but those are all, again, their presentation is there. I've got an idea I want to talk about. I want to talk about these subjects and get these points across in the video, and I try to get into my head before I make the video, and then I go at it, you know. And, you know, it's frustrating for me because I get off topic and I don't say things I want to say later on, you know. And I try too hard, you know. It's no fun for me. It's no fun. It's like work. Even trying to explain this to you guys, it makes me tense and unhappy. I'm unhappy. But, you know, I'm kind of excited to come out here today and make this video. If I wasn't going to make a video tonight, I kind of want to smoke my pipe, my new pipe, which is doing pretty well, by the way. But I was kind of excited to come out here and talk about this, because I'm going to try this. I'm going to make kind of rambling, general videos and talk about stuff that happened during my day, I thought about. Because so often, there's a couple of things that I want to talk about. So often I see things in the news and I say, God, I want to make a video about that. I even put it in my list, but I never do. You know, by the time it's time to talk about it, I'm making a video and I get down to that in my list, you know, by the time I get down there, see all my little topics I've got here? She cheated, but it was an accident. By the time I get to talk about that current event, the current event's so dead that I don't want to talk about it anymore. I don't feel like it. And today, what I'm talking about is I saw this last night. I saw it in the day, and it was a football player. I think it was a college football player. Maybe he was a professional football player. I don't know. And he punched a woman in the face in a bar, and it's on camera. and then, of course, the entire media comes down on him. You know, he's been fired from his job playing football, either, I don't know if it's in college or where it is. So I gotta get this crap off my pewter plate, which I got on my pipe and my phone on. He's been fired, you know. His career is over. You know, he's been fired, he's done. He's a black dude, you know, got his hat on backwards or sideways or whatever, you know. And it's right there on the camera. It's a pretty blonde chick he punches in the face. But here's the thing, and you know, he's being charged. He's being charged with assault and battery and stuff. You know, I'm watching the video. This fucking bitch is trying to punch him in the face, and she does. She punches him first. I mean, she goes like this. She's drunk. I don't know what the altercation was about. I don't know what started it. You know, I mean, you know, but she's, you know, goes like this. You know, and he grabs her arm, you know, with his left hand, you know, and trying to stop her. You know, and he's got a drink in his other hand, you know, and she's struggling, trying to get at him. And then she hauls off and punches him with her left hand, and she does clip him a little bit. They say she missed, but she does clip him a little bit in the face. Well, you know, shit. He's a guy, and, you know, guys get pissed off. He puts a drink in his other hand and freaking baps her in the face, you know. And I just saw the prosecutor on TV saying, well, you know, she was assaulted, you know, and battered by this man, and we're charging him with this and that and everything, and the interviewer says, well, you're charging her? No, we're not charging her. Well, but we see she punched him first. Well, she punched him first, but that's because he was manhandling her. Well, the manhandling was, you know, and I'm not defending this guy because he's black. I don't give a shit what color he is. I'm not all cultural Marxist and need to defend blacks. Oh, blacks are always the victim. No, they're not always the victim. Frequently, they're the victimizers and shit, crimes. And you look at the statistics, it's horrible. I'm not a liberal. But I'm just saying, this guy, in this particular instance, he's grabbing her because she's rearing back to punch him. And she's all aggressive. He's trying to protect himself. And then she punches him with the other hand, which, by the way, you know, you can't forget about the other hand. It's like the old trick in school where someone goes like this, whack, and smacks with the other hand. Bang, you know. Anyway, but she punches him first. And they ask, was she going to be charged? No. No charge will be filed against her. No charges there. But his career is over. He's going to go to jail. He's going to have to go to trial and spend $100,000 defending himself because this crazy bitch tried to punch him. And here's where Kale's anti-feminism kicks in. Leaving the country, you know, of feminism and of supposed equality of men and women. Men and women are the same. We're the same. They're the same. We're the same. Except for maybe slight physical differences in strength. But here we have a situation where we have a man and woman who are the same, supposed to be equal and treated equally under the law. But she attacks him. He hits back. And look who's going to jail. Look who got arrested. Look whose career is ruined. You know? She hit him first. Clearly she hit him first. And she was trying to attack him before this happened. This rips the face off of feminism and shows what a bunch of bullshit feminism is. Because, you know, they want to talk about equality and all the bullshit. But in fact, that's not how it works. You know, women want to have all their equality when it comes to getting good things in life for themselves. Okay? Want to getting jobs and this, that, and the other thing and other privileges. But when it comes to punching guys in the face, where they act like men, I am woman, I am strong, I am independent, I can do whatever I want to do, I can punch this guy in the face. When it comes to that, guess what? All the old cultural stuff kicks in. She's a woman, you can't hit a woman. And I don't think you should hit women, by the way. I never hit one. Never saw my father even raise his voice to my mom. I'm just saying you can't have it both ways. You can't have a situation where, you know, women all have all this equal rights, feminism shit, and they get to do whatever a man can do, you know, and get to work as a police officer, even though they're not really qualified because they're not strong enough or mentally aggressive enough, and combat soldiers and all the rest. But at the same time, if they start a fight in the bar and punch some dude, oh, they get a complete free pass. Pussy privilege, no, she's a woman. We can't charge her with a crime. She's a female. She has a vagina. Let her go. Pretty ridiculous. In his case, there's no win situation for him. Because his punch didn't knock her out. The bitch didn't go down. Not only is he being charged, his career's ruined, which isn't funny, really. But he's the guy who couldn't punch a girl out. He lost the fight, basically. He punched her, she didn't go down. If I punch a girl, she's going down. But he punched this bitch, and she didn't go down. He kept going on. At least you're going to punch a bitch, you know, at least make it count, you know. Don't look like a pansy on camera, you know. He just can't win. But it's just interesting how the prosecutor frames the whole thing, you know. And speaking of framing things and racist stuff, I saw a video tonight on TV of a white guy who got the living shit kicked out of him, who got sucker punched, and probably knockout game, I don't know. But he's down on the ground, they're beating the crap out of him, his face is totally bloody. Bunch of blacks hovering around laughing about it, and screaming whitey and all this racist stuff. And when the police officer wrote the crime up, they said it was a racial bias crime against a white person. When he submitted it the next day, the captain, whoever, someone in the police department changed it all. They wiped it all off. No, it's not a racial bias crime. If it had been a black man lying on the ground there, with his face all busted up, he had a busted cheekbone, and all bloody, with a bunch of whites around chanting racial epithets, I guarantee there'd be riots right now in that city. There'd be looting and riots and all sorts of crime and crazy stuff by certain people. But because it's a white man, all of a sudden, and that's again the problem I have with political correctness and all this racial shit. It doesn't work both ways. It doesn't go both ways. You know, if a black person does something like this, bloop, the news media generally won't even report that it was a black person that did it, but also, that'll be kept quiet. But second of all, there'll be no racial bias. And again, they changed the form. They threw out all the old stuff. They changed the form, saying it's no racial bias, just a crime. I have a problem with that. It should go both ways, or not at all. And then another thing in the news today got me kind of pissed off today, you know, disgusted. A woman, a young girl, 18 or 19 or something like that, maybe 17, in San Francisco, I don't know if you heard about this, but an illegal alien who had been deported 5 times shot her for no reason. Just shot her. Supposedly he found a gun. He says he just found this gun. And then just shot it for the fun of it, I guess. Some damn thing. I don't know why I did it, but he doesn't have an explanation. He's a drunk and a drug addict, and he looks like a freaking mutant, for Christ's sake. And he just looks like a total bum, in my opinion. I'm sorry, he does. He's just a disgusting-looking person. Killed this poor, beautiful young girl. She died in her father's arms, you know, saying things like, "Dad, why me? Why this happened? Please help me, Dad. Please help me, help me." And dies in his arms. They arrest him. This guy had been deported 5 times. And this last time, because San Francisco is a sanctuary city. A sanctuary city is a city that refuses to cooperate with INS. The immigration guys, the federal immigration police, refuses to cooperate with them. Will hide and protect illegal aliens in their city for whatever crazy, liberal, fucked up, fucked in head reason. This guy had been deported 5 times. This last time, I guess, INS wanted him. San Francisco refused to give him up, I guess. Wouldn't give him up to the INS. And now he's killed a beautiful young girl whose family will never recover from this. She's dead. She'll never recover, certainly. Her family will never recover. What I also find interesting about this, it's a gun crime. If this were not illegal aliens involved, I'm sure Obama would be on TV saying, "We've got to ban guns. This gun was found." The guy said he found the gun in the street wrapped in a shirt. I doubt that. It could be. But it would be a big gun controller. But because it's an illegal alien doing, they won't say a word about that. It's okay if illegal aliens misuse guns. But if a regular person does, a citizen does it, then we need to have gun control. Just sickening. And on this story, they showed a map of the country and so-called sanctuary states which will not literally harbor illegal aliens. You know, I'm not going to fucking say immigrants or undocumented workers. Fuck all that bullshit PC crap. I won't do it, ever. They're illegal fucking aliens. They show this map of the country, and they have several states colored, showing, color, that's how the word you use. Talking about illegal aliens from Mexico. But showing the states that are sanctuary states. Fucking my state's one of them. Montana is a sanctuary state. I just can't believe it. Makes me sick. So my state legislature decided that we're going to be a sanctuary state. We're not going to cooperate with INS. That explains to me why when I go to Walmart over here, it's full of Mexicans who don't speak English. You wonder why I'm sick and tired of all this illegal immigration? That's one of the reasons why. My town is filling up with illegal aliens. I'm sick of it. And their culture is not a culture I wonder. I've been to Mexico. I've seen the kind of crime down there and stuff going on down there. Not all Mexicans are bad people. There's some great Mexicans. I've had friends who are Mexicans who owned a business here. I lived next to a Mexican guy who was a real decent guy, a construction worker. He owned a construction company here in town. But it's a different culture. And it's a culture we don't need up here. We just don't. I'm sorry. Don't like it. I'm sorry. It's just true. It's not about the skin color, that they're brown people. It's about we don't need people from other countries, the third world countries that have a lot more crime and more likely to do crime and bring drugs. Recently, funny hair man, the guy's running for president, the name is right on the tip of my tongue. The guy runs the Miss Universe pageant and, he does the You're Fired deal. God, I can't remember his name, it's terrible, no memory. He got trouble for saying that, making a rape comment about Mexicans, What he was saying was that of the Mexican women who come across the border from Mexico, 80% of those women are raped by Mexican men, for Christ's sake, on the way here, as they're traveling across our border. They're raped by Mexican men traveling with them. That's pretty horrible statistics. Do we want those men in our country? I don't. Our prisons are clogged right now with Mexicans who have committed crimes and are in prison right now because of it. I want borders. I mean, a country's not a country. A country just isn't a piece of land with a government. A country is a country of like-minded people, for Christ's sake. And when you bring people into the country who don't think the way you do, and are more criminal-minded possibly, or more percentage of the population is more criminal-minded, or at least the ones coming here are, you're changing your country into something else. That's something not good. I just can't believe it. I just can't. It just amazes me. Got a beautiful girl dead for no reason. All because San Francisco is a sanctuary city and refuses to deport these people when they catch them. They get caught for various crimes. They won't do that. They don't call in and say, get rid of this person. Get them out of our country. No, they keep them. They let them go back on the streets of San Francisco. And this is not the first time this kind of thing has happened. There's a lot of this going on across the country. And I don't really care if it's one instance of it. One instance is too much, having a young girl, beautiful young girl shot for no good reason. Just because he felt like shooting somebody, I guess, because he's drunk and on drugs. You know? And he shouldn't be here. You know, it's just sick. And the federal government, the Obama administration, has made this easy to happen. They don't care either. You know? Another case they talked about, which was some Mexican guy who was an illegal alien who, for the DREAM Act, was allowed to stay, and he killed somebody. It's like, Jesus. And one murder like that is too much. What they should do is what they talked about doing back in the 80s, which is make punitive actions against businesses who hire these people. That's what it's all about. All these Californians want to have cheap maids and cheap cooks to work in their house and cheap gardeners to work in their gardens. You know, basically a cheap labor force. And I say anybody caught hiring an illegal alien, you know, and maybe make a law, you got to have some kind of a documentation, say a birth certificate before you hire somebody, proving you're an American citizen. That wouldn't be that hard. You get caught hiring a legal alien, you lose a third or half of your wealth. You got $1 million home, guess what? You're going to have to go shopping for a $500,000 home because you just lost half of it. If you made a law like that, believe me, the legal aliens would stop coming because there would be no jobs for them. You know, they'd be done. The last thing we ought to do is have a lottery for legal aliens to get caught. One out of every 1,000, say, to have them put their name in the lottery. And those ones who win the lottery get to go work on a farm, maybe breaking rocks for a year on bread and water. Or a couple of years. And if they've been caught before, then maybe it gets up to 2 or 3 years. Let them break rocks in the hot sun. See if they want to come up here again and sneak into our country. And steal things and do crimes and sell drugs and rape people and whatever else they're doing up here. And I know not all Mexicans do that. I'm well aware of that. But still, there are too damn many people in this country in the first damn place. Too damn many. So much of this being a relaxing video, huh? But it's not good. It's not a good thing. You know, just letting pell-mell anybody come into your country. A country is not just a piece of land with a bunch of people on it. You know, it's about having a common group of people who have common ideas and common ideals. You know, speak the same language. What's up there? Is it? There it is. I'm sorry to get so serious, but these things bother me. It really does. This was a beautiful young girl, a beautiful American, shot by someone who should not be here. That the town and state he lives in actually protected him and kept him from being sent back. It's just so wrong. It is so damn wrong, for Christ's sake. You know? It's just so wrong. I'm sorry, but it is. It makes me sick. I see that young girl, I see what could have been my daughter, you know? It's just so damn wrong, for Christ's sake, you know? It didn't have to be that way. It just didn't. Well, I suppose that's your daily dose for the day. I can't think of else to talk about. I've got something that happened today, by the way, though. I should talk about it now, but I won't. I should make a separate grab video about that one. You know. And I don't know why people who are Mexican who live here, who are real serious citizens, would want a bunch of other Mexicans here just because they're Mexicans, for Christ's sake. You know, I'm Irish and probably a little Scottish and mostly English. But I wouldn't want a bunch of English hooligans imported into my country either. If there were millions of them coming here, you know, these days, English people are good people, great people, but there are a lot of English hooligans who live there. know what I'm saying? I wouldn't want them by the millions imported in here either, for my sake. Really sick, sad thing about the whole deal is it's being done on purpose by left-wingers in this country. They want to destabilize the country. They want to destroy the ethnic identity of our country and the American identity, and they want to pour as many foreigners in here as they can who won't share our goals and our attitudes. And because they can divide and conquer, they can have total power. That's what it's all about. You know, just like California is now a one-party state. The Republican can't get elected for dog catcher there, basically, because they've imported so many Mexicans there and so many illegal aliens that it's basically, I mean, like, I think I heard like 80% of people who live in Mexico in California now are Mexicans or Latin Americans or whatever, Latin. You know, and a lot of them are poor people because, you know, they came from poor countries, and therefore they want all the welfare and the free stuff that the Democratic Party offers. So Republicans can't get elected anymore. You know, sensible economics doesn't fly in California anymore. And one of these days, I guarantee you, when California goes bust, and it could happen any time, when it goes bankrupt, they're going to come to you and say, "Oh, please give us a bailout. Oh, the rest of the country's got to give us a bailout." And the president, whoever it is going to get up and stand on camera and say, "We must bail out California's economy. We must give them several trillion dollars and pay off their debts because they spent the last 15, 20 years educating legal aliens in schools there who aren't even our citizens, but if they come across the border..." I mean, every damn day, Mexicans march their kids across the border into California for the day and put them in our schools. And you guys, then the Californians pay for that shit. And we're going to have to pay for it eventually. With trillions of dollars in aid for California. Well, I don't think so. I'll be out in the street with signs saying, "No, thank you. No, thank you for that nonsense." It's ridiculous. It's like Greece right now, you know. I don't know, anybody who has a 401k right now knows what happened here a week or so ago. Greece defaulted on their payment to the IMF or whatever it is. And the whole, you know, the reverberations of just that pretty much tanked our stock market. But Greece has been practicing insane socialism for years, the same way California does. You know, like 60% of people in Greece work for the government, you know, for crazy. They don't produce anything. That's not a job. Jobs produce something. If you cut down a tree, if you're a lumberjack, you know, lumberman, you know, you're taking a tree which is a nice tree, but sitting there in the forest is not economically worth anything, you know, maybe for tourism. You cut that tree down, like you do here in Montana, he's actually creating something that, once he cuts it down, he's created a valuable thing, an asset. He's taken the mill, people there, they cut it into boards. Again, it's worth more as boards than it was even just as a tree. Those boards are taken to a site, and a bunch of construction workers build a house, a building of some kind out of it. Now you've taken something which is, I'm not saying trees are worthless, but worth, you know, very little. You made it into a building that's now an asset. Where there was nothing before, there's actually wealth. They've created wealth through their labor, you know. But when you take a government employee, I'm sorry that you guys work for the government, but this is the truth. You take a government employee who just shuffles papers around back and forth. They're not creating any wealth of any kind. They're stealing wealth from taxpayers who are working for a living, who actually create wealth. That's what a real job is. That's what a real job is, when you're actually creating wealth, you know, that didn't exist before, you know. If you're a leather worker, you know, my son's making leather products these days in front of it. You know, if you make a leather, some kind of a leather piece that sells, some kind of something out of leather, You've transferred your labor into something valuable, you know, that before was just a piece of leather that isn't really good for anything, into something which is actually valuable, something that is sellable. You've created wealth that never existed before, and you sell it to someone who gives you money for it. You've made it something valuable, but yet the person who gives you the money for it still has something valuable. It's still worth what he paid for it. It's like he really hasn't even spent money. I mean, it's still worth what he paid for it. You know, it's like if you make a handmade knife, you know. That's creating wealth. That's creating something, you know. That's what real jobs do. And if you're a shoe salesman, you're part of the economic life of the country. You create wealth because you're selling that product. You know, that's what wealth is. That's what, you know, that's what creation of wealth and money is. But if you're sitting in an office working for the government, shuffling papers back and forth, You're just taking money away from somebody else and putting it in your pocket. And what you do creates no wealth. Now, an exception would be the post office, something that I actually like, because they are part of that process. When I buy something on eBay and it gets shipped to me, they're part of the process of that whole business, you know. But just shuffling papers back and forth and taxing people and taking their money, that's not creating wealth. It's not what I call a real job. And honestly, I don't call it a real job. It's not creating wealth of any kind. It's not involved in the creation of wealth, you know. Well, this wasn't a relaxing chat with Kel I intended to be, but you probably won't like this video. That's kind of too bad. These things are on my mind today. You know, watching these news stories just makes me sick. A young girl dead. A young man whose life has been ruined because some crazy bitch in a bar, who looked drunk to me, by the way, who just looked drunk and aggressive. She tries to punch him, and actually did hit him, I think, a little bit. He punches back, and he's going to jail? Probably this kid, black dude's got a bunch of other demerits or problems he's had in the past. Well, that's fine, but that doesn't mean having to do with what happened in that bar. I don't care what he's done in the past. I care about the crime he's been charged with and what's ruined his career. That's the problem I have with feminism. It's not really equal or equality. It's really just about special privileges to women. Where are the feminists protesting the fact that she didn't get charged? I don't hear any in them anywhere. You're not going to hear anyone. In fact, you'll hear feminists come out and saying, yeah, he deserves to be. No one should hit a woman. Well, if we're all equal, she shouldn't hit a man either. She should at least be charged too. Well, I think he was just defending himself, pure and simple. Someone smacks you in the face, do you not have the right to hit back? Jesus. Anyway, now you'll probably say you don't like this video. Well, they won't always be about stuff like this, but I think we'll make videos just kind of rambling and talking, you know, with you as a friend, and you may not like my opinion, but you know, some of you may, though, you know. But these are things that are on my mind. I fear for our nation. I really do. I don't care for left-wing politics. I think it's evil and destructive. I'm not a Republican. I'm a libertarian, mainly. You know, I fear for our country. I really do. I really do. I fear for it, where it's going. And most people are just asleep, you know, they're sleeping. They have no idea what's going on. Getting smoke out of this, I can barely feel it. See, I put BCA, lane limited BCA in the bottom part. Something I've gotten down to. And then I put McClellan's vanilla black Cavendish on top. Vanilla black Cavendish is a better flavor. BCA is not bad, but the BBC is better. And this pipe's smoking pretty well. It's got a big ass bowl. It's almost 2 inches deep, which means you can get a good. The bottom part acts as a nice filter for the tobacco, which filters out any tongue bite or any nonsense. Feels good in the hand. Yeah, I didn't say, but my new idea for the channel is to have kind of a lifestyle magazine. You know, that's what I've been thinking about in my head. I've made 4 videos now explaining what I wanted to do. Gentleman Scholar put his Manly Man videos, you know. And that's kind of where I'm going with the channel. You know, when I was younger, I was lucky enough to have a father that, you know, talked about stuff. And I had older brothers who'd sit around and talk about politics and this and that and the other thing and things going on. And when I was in Checker Auto Parts, when I was in college and when I was working my psych degree, you know, one of the assistant managers there named Howard Olderguy, he'd taken that job. It wasn't a very good job. He'd taken the job because he wanted to live in Montana. He liked hunting and liked wilderness activities. He left a very good job back east to come back here and live in Montana just because of that. And I rented a little duplex, part half of a duplex, you know, a little cheesy house he was living in with his family. And he made a big sacrifice because he really wanted to live the Montana life, you know, hunting and jeeping. And he had a Jeep. And back when things were quiet and there was nothing going on, we'd sit around and talk about stuff, politics, but also a lot about women. You know, he had a lot of stories to tell when he lived back east. And an older, wiser man like that to actually give me the time to talk about stuff that was on his mind, you know, and kind of mentor me a little bit was a really nice thing. And then when, you know, years later, I got in business with my father. I joined the karate club here in town that I was with for 20 years or whatever. I was getting a little older myself. We had a lot of young men join our club. They'd join for a while and then quit. They'd be with us for a while. Some were with us for a long time. But after we were working out, we'd stand out in front of the gym and we'd talk about, you know, the class. But also we'd talk about everything, women, politics. And some of those older guys would try to help the younger guys understand. You know, they were in relationships with women, things were getting weird. We'd try to help them understand what they were dealing with because we'd had some experience. They hadn't. I think men should do that. I think men should help other men, younger men, if they can. Older guys should pass down, because we've lost that. We have so many unwed mothers, not unwed, but so many single moms these days who get pregnant by some dude in some bar, and they pop out the kid without a father, and the kid, if it's a male child, never has a real reference. A lot of these young men these days, they don't have a reference of having a male father. They don't know what it's like, and they don't know what they've missed. I'm sorry, but they don't. The other young men these days, was one that was on my channel here last week, and he was all pissed off because I was making MGTOW and anti-feminism videos. He said, these videos are intolerable. He called my videos intolerable. He was all mad. He's basically telling me to knock it off. Don't talk about women. He's probably raised by a single mom. He's never had a father, a dad, or any male figures in his life who would tell him, hey, the straight story about stuff like that. You know, they would talk sense, you know. He probably thinks that women should never be criticized. He's basically white knighting. That's a man who's been raised by a single mom, probably, and jumps to the defense of women no matter what. He probably thinks the black dude who smacked the woman in the bar deserves to have the worst thing happen to him because he hit a woman. Well, if she's a feminist, we live in a feminist society, she shouldn't be hitting him in the first place, and he has the right to hit her back. You know, but that's... it's all about equality until, you know, a woman gets punched in the face because she started a fight. She chose to act like a man. And I don't believe in hitting women. I really don't. And but I'm not saying I want to go back to traditional type days, you know, where women are little flowers and need to be protected. I'm just saying, you can't have it both ways, ladies. You can't act like men and punch women out in bars and then act like the victim when you get hit back. Anyway, the thing is, my idea about this channel is, it's why I started making the MGTOW videos, you know, videos about feminism and women in general. Because I think it's good for men to have other men to talk to and to listen to and get opinions. It doesn't mean you have to agree with all my opinions. It's always young men in college generally that react that way to those kind of videos, because a lot of these young men have taken women's studies courses. You know, a lot of these guys are nerdy guys who don't have women themselves. If you go on YouTube and watch videos on feminism, like, you know, there's one where a bunch of feminists are trying to block a speaker at a college who's speaking about, you know, men's rights. There's always a couple really geeky, unattractive men with these women who are on their side, you know. And you just know these guys are hoping to get laid. They're hoping to get a little touch, you know. They think if they, you know. If they support these feminist women, you know, they're going to get laid, you know. That they'll take them back to the dorms and strip their clothes off and slobber all over their knob. Oh boy, it's going to be great. If I just... get lockstep with all these feminists and, oh, do marches with them and stuff. But that's not how it works. I've heard feminists say privately, you know, that they don't like men like that. They look upon them as weak, as sissies. I don't mean gay. I mean just weak sisters. You know, they don't like that. They'll go and you know, they'll go on the march with these dudes, but when it comes down to, you know, having sex with them, they won't bother. They'll go find some aggressive guy, some dick, you know, as they would call him, you know, some non-feminist kind of guy. Now you got a funny story. When I left after my divorce, met a girl online, and we'd seen each other once. That's a euphemism, if you're wondering. And then I decided not sure I want to date her anymore. Some strange things. She seemed a little bit odd to me. I thought maybe she's doing drugs or something. I won't date someone as a drug user. So I basically told her that, and she said fine. So she made a date with a guy that was just a friend. You know, and this guy's a real straight-laced kind of religious guy. I think he was a Mormon, as a matter of fact. And she just saw him, she said, totally he's a friend, and I don't doubt that, really. But to me, it was obvious he was trying to get in your pants. I think he was actually even a married guy, I'm not sure. So she made this date, supposed to be dinner and a movie. And she said she had to have sex with him, and she was the kind of girl, I believe that, because she's very open about her sexuality. She had no problem talking about, you know, who she had done. And he also had no doubt whatsoever he wanted to get sex, and maybe it would have happened at some point. But they had been doing this, going to movies and going to dinner as friends for some time. And I think she was just using him, was my thought, because he's a very passive, very shy guy. And he's doing the old friend thing. I'm just a friend, you know, hoping that someday just she'll turn to him and grab him or something. I suppose that's what he was basically doing the old, you know, passive friend thing, thinking that someday she'll turn and want him, you know, which isn't going to happen because girls like guys are stronger and more aggressive. So after we talked, she made this date after we talked because I basically was saying I didn't want to see her again. Then she called back, or I did, you know, and we got talking. I realized she wasn't on drugs. And I mean, she said, well, why don't we get together tonight, you know? And she said, well, the guy's coming over right now. We're going on this date. We're going to a dinner. He's buying me dinner. Then we're going to go to a movie. I said, well, that's fine, you know. Why don't you just skip the movie? So she goes and has dinner with him, which she pays for. And then begs off the movie. I don't want to go to the movie. I don't feel like going to the movie tonight. And within 10 minutes, she's over at my house on her knees, taking care of business. You know, it's your typical weak, you know, kind of a wussy guy who doesn't, you know, hasn't really realized yet women like stronger men. You got to make moves, you know what I'm saying? You know, and I used to be that kind of guy. I know what the kind of guy is. You know, I used to be a very shy person. You know, and sometimes, somewhere in my 20s, things changed. Maybe being in karate long term, I don't know. I changed the guy I am now, but I used to be that guy. I know that guy. I know him well. But, so he paid for an expensive dinner, which she followed with my dessert. I gave her a dessert, she ate it. Funny. At least to me. It was a nice evening. Especially considering I don't usually buy women dinners and things like that. I mean, if I was dating a girl and having sex with her, I'd buy her occasional dinner, but I'd never buy a girl dinner if I'm not banging her. Just no way. I wouldn't buy a girl a drink either for the same reason. Not if I was certain I was going to be banging her soon. Well, I'm curious what you guys think. My videos won't always be as political as this one. I won't always be talking about legal immigration or, you know, or feminism in my videos. I'll make them up. But rather than make stock videos about those subjects, maybe I'll just make these fireside chat videos and we'll talk about those things as I would with any guys. I mean, if you were sitting here, we'd be talking about this stuff. You know, I'd say, do you see that today about that girl who was shot in that horrible? And we'd be talking about that stuff, you know. Did you see about that football player who got arrested for smacking a girl because she punched him first and he gets arrested? We you know, if this was after karate class right now, we'd be talking about those things. We'd be going, yeah, I can't believe it. We'd be talking about those things. Those would be a subject of conversation. guys be standing around shaking their head, I can't believe it. I cannot believe that, you know, they arrested him when she hit him first. And it's on video. Now, if they charged her as well, it might be something, you know. Charge her to then charge him, that might be something, though that wouldn't make much sense. But she's got never charge. She's the punch thrower. No, not never charge. It's called pussy privilege, if you know what that's called. Privilege for having a vagina. Having a vag.
I've got a vag. I can punch guys whenever I want to and expect not to get punched back. Of course I have a vagina. The vagina gives me a pass.
Mm-hmm. Actually, I'm not for any women. I'm just saying, it can't have it both ways. You know? I'd like to go back to a world where women don't understand they can't be hitting men, and they can't be doing stuff like that because they're not men, and that men don't punch women, you know? That's what I'd like to be, you know?
Well, I'm getting down to the bottom of what... I'm getting down to the BC. I don't want to smoke the BC, so I'm going to go... But there it is. Here, just for fun. I'll give you a close above it. It's a pretty nice pipe, actually. It was kind of dirty. I had to clean it. It's quite a job. I didn't videotape the cleaning of it because it was like 6 in the morning yesterday. I was still filming around. I decided to clean it on the spur of the moment. It's just so complicated to film it and clean it both. I just wanted to get it done, so I just went for it. Just cleaned her up. Cleaned up, got it going. But that's a pretty nice pipe. $89. 89 plus shipping. I think maybe it was $89. No, maybe it was $89 altogether. I don't know. Maybe I'll place the purchase video of it. I don't know what I'm going to do now. But anyway, well, that's it. Long video, I know, but give me your opinion. Of course, here's the thing. Anyone who actually watches this entire video is probably going to enjoy watching it. So the guys who don't watch the whole video, they won't be here that I'm asking for opinions. So, but this may be too long, but anyway, so I think we're just making videos like this from now on. And I can talk about stuff like feminine, that woman getting hit in the bar, which is also anti-feminism in the video. You know, it's a huge moth coming after me. Well, that's it, folks. Thanks for watching. Hope you're enjoying your pipes and cigars, enjoying your life, enjoying your manly videos, because that's what I'm going to be making from now on, I think. Kind of chats and talks. Howard Stern can do it. Maybe I can do it. I'm not talented like he is, but maybe I can make videos just talking about stuff in life, and maybe it'll be interesting. I certainly love watching Howard Stern videos. That was my point about the whole Howard Stern thing. But I certainly love watching his videos, and you know, even though they're very long on YouTube, you know, I still enjoy watching. You know, hearing what he's talking about. You know, maybe you will too. I don't know. We're gonna try this for a while. I've got a bunch of other videos already made. I've got 30, 40 videos I've already made, which I can put up in between. But we're gonna be putting up these rambling talking videos. I'm talking about men stuff and guy things and what's on my mind today, you know. And those two things about the puncher and the woman getting shot by an illegal alien, that's on my mind today. That disturbs me. You know, that disturbs me greatly. Very much. Especially the illegal alien killing some poor, sweet, beautiful girl who's a decent person who died in her father's arms. All because San Francisco is a little bunch of fucktards who have to have a sanctuary city and protect illegal aliens. Why? They're not supposed to be here. I don't know. I don't understand it. I don't know why even Latin people would want them here. I don't understand that. What a sour note to end a video on. All right. I'm going to go. Smoke that bowl down the bottom. This will be a long pipe smoke. That'll be kind of good for these kind of videos. Thanks for watching, guys. Let me gals and gals, too, for that matter. Let me know what you think about the idea of changing my channel into more things like that. You probably won't like it. You know, oh, we don't want that. You know, we want small 3-minute videos. I don't know what to do. I really don't. All right, well, that's it, folks. Thanks for watching. And we'll talk to you later. Might put another bowl in this pipe. Smoke another bowl out of this thing. Some different tobacco. I don't know. Maybe I'll put some cherry tobacco in it. That'll be an abortion, wouldn't it? Talk to you later.